when you advocate for yourself, there's some responsibilities in how you advocate for yourself. For instance, are you complaining or are you educating and sharing? Because the difference between a complaint and educating and sharing information with someone is often your word choice and your tone, and maybe your body language to boot. There's two sides to this coin. It is very difficult to advocate for yourself if you have unrealistic expectations when you advocate for what you want and need. See, from my perspective, I want to be heard. I want to be listened to. I can't get a guarantee that the person will do what I ask, will do what I want and need, but I sure as heck want to be listened to and heard. What that looks like is I want the person to ask me some questions about why I want and need what I need, how it's impacting me to not have it. I want them to be curious. I want them to understand the scope of what I'm advocating for. I don't want them to be in a rush. I don't want them to have to race to another meeting. I want them to spend time to listen and ask thoughtful questions to understand the impact of the points I'm raising. If your attitude is they just don't get it, have you had an opportunity? Do you want to take advantage of an opportunity to advocate for yourself so you can educate? You can share the impact of what's going on for you and the requests being made. If you have told yourself, Mark, I've already talked to them. I've had two conversations with them. It doesn't work. You sure? Because when you had the initial conversation to advocate for yourself, did you share the impact? Did you share the why? Did you share how it's affecting your happiness, productivity, and motivation in the workplace? Or did you just complain?